Hey guys, welcome to our website ETL testing tutorial. So today we are going to learn about what all commands come under different languages of SQL. So before we proceed towards the commands, let me first explain you a scenario. Like, let us assume that this is the SQL platform where we have to work, okay? And now I want to create a database in this platform. So for creating a database in the platform, which command you want? You want a create command. Okay, so the create command will enable you to create a database in your platform as well as a table. So here I'll create a table with the help of create command. Now this is my database. Let us assume that I named the database as db1 and now the table name is tb1. Okay. So after creating the table in my database, now what I want to create rows and columns basically. Okay. So for creating rows or creating columns, so adding rows and columns, what we want is the alter command. With the help of alter command, we can add columns or we can drop the columns afterwards when the table is already created. Fine. Now after creating the after adding the rows and the columns, now we have to insert some values. Like, let us assume that the first row, the first column name is name and the next column name is containing the name as age and the next one as ID, roll number. Okay. Let us assume that we are dealing with the table of student data. Okay. And now, so the caller command. Now, when I want to insert some values, like the first value I'll insert as 3, the age as 25, and the roll number as 47. Okay. So for inserting values, what I want basically, I want the insert command. With the help of insert command, we can insert value. After the values are inserted, let us assume that I want to update some column. Like, let us insert some more values so that we can differentiate it. So Nali, her age is 16 and her roll number is 71. Okay, fine. Now, and 24 and the roll number is 13. Okay, fine. So let us assume that there are 3 records in this table. Fine. So from these 3 records, now I want to update some record. Like, I want to update the roll number of the 3rd record. So how can I update the data that is existing in the table? So for that, what we'll do, we'll go with the update command. So with the help of update command, you can make changes in the existing data that is present in your table. Now, what if I want to delete some record? Let me remove this. Yeah. So what if I want to delete this record, the second one? So for that, whenever you want to delete a single record from your table, then you have to go with delete command. So delete command can delete a particular value from your table. Now what if you want to delete all the records from your table? So for that, you can go with truncate command. So the truncate command will delete all the values from your table, but what it will do basically, it will delete these values, but it may not delete the schema in the table, fine, but the values will get truncated, the values will get deleted, fine. Now What if I want to delete the whole table from this schema? I don't want this table in my database. I want to remove the whole table. Then for that, what we'll do, we'll go with the drop command. So drop command will delete the whole table, including the values that is present in that table. Okay. So now let us assume that you want to delete a single record. Okay, fine. I want to delete this record from my table. This one must get removed. Okay, let us. Okay, I want to delete this record. Now, after deleting that record, I come to know that I did not want to delete that. So, can I fetch it back? Yes, I can. So, with the help of rollback transaction or rollback command, we can fetch the deleted values as well. Now, let us assume that I have made some changes in my table and I don't want anybody the things I have made, roll back the changes that I have made. So for that, what we can do, I can go with the commit command. I can commit the changes so that whatever changes I have made cannot be changed again. Nobody can roll back it. Okay, so for that, we can go with commit command. Now the cutter, drop and truncate comes under DDL language. And the insert, update, delete comes DML language. Let me write it down here. Yeah, wait a second. So these all come under DML language. And the rollback and commit comes under transit control language. Fine. Let me write in capital. Yeah. So, hope you have understand the things. Now, what if you have inserted some values in your table? Now, what you want is, you want to check what all values are there in my table. So, for that, you can go with the select query. So the select command comes within DQL or DRL language. That means data query language or data retrievable language. What the select command is doing, basically the select command will fetch all the values that are present in the table. Fine. So now one more thing is left, that is merge command. See, the DML language also consists of merge command. Whenever there are two tables in your database, let us assume that first table and the second table, and both are having a single common column, or both are having a common column, then I want to, then how can I perform this? I can do that with the help of this merge command. And this merge command comes under DML language. Fine. These all are the diff. Now, let us assume that we have created some more databases in the SQL platform. Or let us assume that there are some default databases in my SQL platform. And now I want to get the access of those databases that are already existing there. So how can I get the access from those databases? For that, I'll grant the privileges of DBA to those databases so that I can get the access. If you want to get back the privileges from some of the databases that are existing in the platform, then you can go with revoke. I'll come with all of these things practically as well. We'll discuss about all of these things. Fine. So hope you have got this things, how, what all commands to come under different languages. Fine. So now, as I was talking about the DDL, DML, DQL, and all of these languages, so now I'll go through the queries for all of these languages. So the first query, let us go through the SQL platform, that is the SQL Management Studio. taking a little bit time to get opened. I'll wait until it is opened. Yeah. I'll go for. I won't go with Windows authentication. I'll go with SQL Server authentication and my server name. I'll browse for that. Database. Yeah, this one. Okay. Go with SQL Server authentication and a system administrator. And I'll go with the password. So it is connected. Now I'll go with new query. So first of all, we'll create a database in this platform. Then I'll show you how to create tables and then we'll insert the values. So for creating database, you'll go with the create command, create database. I'll name the database as Priyanka. Fine. Now, before I create this database, let me show you some more terms. Let me explain about this platform. Like, see, this is the execute button. Whenever we are running some queries, we'll execute through this button. And whenever I want a new window or new platform for running my queries, I'll go with this new query. This is basically providing me the work area where I can run, where I can write the queries. And here I can save the file. I can open a new file, new project as well. I can open the folders, or here it is providing a drop down list which is consisting of different kind of databases that are present in SQL platform. Okay, so when I'll create this database, it will list out in this drop down list. Okay, it will get listed in this drop down list. So I'll execute. As you can see, the command has completed successfully. Now it will show this platform. See, this time it is showing Priyanka as well. So what I'll do, I'll point towards this database which I have created for now. Now I'm going to create the tables. See, the tables or the schemas or the views which I am going to create for now, it will be created under this database which I am pointing towards. Okay. So for creating a table, you will go with create table, table name. So the table name which I have to create is, I'll provide the table name as student. I'll provide ID as the first column. And then I'll provide the data type. It will be of integer data type. And then name column is there, which will be of varchar data type. Whenever you are specifying the varchar type of data, you need to specify the length for the characters. Okay. And then I'll go for address, which will be of again varchar type of data, and I'll provide the data type again. Sorry, length. So create table, table name, execute. So the command has completed successfully, right? Now, after the table is created, we have to insert values in it. So for inserting values, what we'll do, we'll go with insert into table name. So what is my table name? The student, where I'm having ID column, name column, and address column, right? And I will provide the values for them. Like for ID, I'll provide the value as 1. For name, I'll provide Sonali, and the address will be like Chandigarh. Mumbai. Yeah. So this is the syntax for inserting values, and one row is affected. If you want to insert multiple values in a single line, then how can you do that? For that, I'll go for Sona. And here I'll go with Delhi as my address. And for the next value, I'll use a comma separator. Three. And then Rohan is the name. And the place as Kolkata. Kolkata. Yeah. So when you want to insert more than two records or more values, multiple records, then you can follow up the syntax and execute. So now I want to fetch all the records, that which all values are there in my table. So for that, I'll go with the select query. Select star from table name. So the table name is student. As you can see, there are three records. So this is how we can fetch all the records from our table with the help of select command. So this select command was coming under DQL or DRL language. Fine. Now, if I go with the next command, like I have inserted values, I have created a table. Now, what if I want to insert or add one more column in this table? So for that, I'll go with the alter command. Alter table student add column. You don't need to specify this column. I'll add a column for age. I'll provide the data type, and this is done. Okay. So the command has completed successfully. We can check it from here. See, I have successfully added a new column, but there are no values for this. Now, what if I want to update values in this new column? So for that, I'll go for update command. Update table name, that means student. Set column name. What's the column name? It's age. Age equals to 16. 16, where whenever you are going with update command, you have to go through this where clause. Otherwise, you may not be able to update the table. Like, we need a conditions on the basis of which we can update our table. So I'll go with this where clause. I'll also come up that what all clauses we can use in SQL platform. This is the first clause which I'm using for the first time. This is the first clause which I am using. Okay, so I want to set the age as 16 wherever the ID column is containing one of the value. Okay, so one row is affected. If I go with select star from student, execute and see. So this is how you can update the records with the help of update command. Now we have covered create, alter, and update and insert. Now, what if you want to delete a single record from this table? For that, you have to use the delete command. Delete from student where ID is 3. Delete from table name where ID is 3. So, as I have already said that the delete command will help us to delete a particular record from that table. While execute and see, one row is affected, and if I check, this is what I wanted. Right. Now, what if we want to delete all the records that are present in the table? So for that, I'll go with truncate command. So truncate table. Table name. student. Okay. I'll execute this and see the command has completed successfully. Now what the truncate command is doing basically, the truncate command is deleting all the records from the table. If I go with select star from student, no more records are present there, but the schema has not get deleted, right? So for deleting the whole table with the schema, we'll go with the drop command. But before I use drop table name, let me again insert the records. I'll go with insert into this and execute. So two rows are effective. Now if I check the table select star from student, there are two records. And now if I go with drop table name, this command will delete all the records that are present in the table as well as the schema. Now if I go with select command, it will show me an error that student table is not existing in this database. See, invalid object name student. Fine. So if I explain the difference between drop, delete and truncate in a layman term, let me show you. Let us assume that this is a table, this is one more, this is a table, and they are containing the columns as name and ID. The same columns are present in every table, okay, here as well. Now here I am containing the name as Priyanka and the ID is 101. The same value is present over here as well and here. Yeah, again I'll go with another schema and the ID is 201. Control plus C and Control plus V. Fine. So now when I apply delete command over here, as you know that delete comes with where clause. So in the where condition I have to provide that wherever the ID is 101, I want to delete that record. So what it will basically do, it will delete this record from my table. This record will get deleted. Now on the other hand, if I talk about truncate, what truncate will do basically, truncate will delete all the records but not the schema. Like if I say it will delete both the records that are present, but the schema will be present in the database. Fine. Now on the other hand, if I talk about drop command, so what the drop command will do, the drop command will delete the whole table. That means the schema will get deleted as well as the records will get deleted. Hope you have got through the scenario. Okay. Now we have gone through create, alter, drop, truncate, update, insert, delete, and yeah, we are done with all of these things. Now, as I said, like let us assume, let me create this table again, execute and insert the values. Fine. So there are two records. Let me check again. So there are two records. Now, what if I delete some record, like I want to delete this one, this record from my table. After deleting this, I came to know that I did not want to delete this one. I wanted to delete this record, right? So can I fetch it back? Yeah, I can. For that, we'll need a begin transaction before every delete command. So I'll go with begin transaction. I'll go with delete from student where ID is equals to 2. So now if I execute this, so see one row is affected. If you will check the records, that record has got deleted from the table. Now can I get it back? Yes, I can. For that I'll go with rollback, and this time when I'll go with rollback, see the command has completed successfully. If I go with the select command again to fetch the records from the table, see I got the deleted record back. So with the help of begin transaction, whenever we are using a begin transaction before we are using the delete command, then we can roll back that transaction. Now let us assume that I want to delete this record permanently. Okay. And I don't want anybody to make changes in the deletion which I have made. So if I delete this, one row is affected. So after deleting the records, what you can perform is commit. When you will commit, then all the changes which you have made will get saved in your database. And afterwards, if any other user comes and roll back the transaction, so he will get an error message that the rollback is not containing any begin transaction. Fine. So this way you can just keep those changes which you have made in your PC or in your database. So this was all about different commands.